We all know a solar array in space has enormous potential to not only create revenue for SpaceX for more space exploration, but also to fundamentally change the world, just like Starlink is going to. We all depend on electricity after all. But there have always been two problems with EnergyLink. First, the solar panels were too expensive to get into space, and second, how would we transmit the electricity? Starting off with cost, the cost of getting things to space has always been extremely high, with the space shuttle having a cost per kilogram to space of $54,500, and even Falcon 9 with a cost of $2,720 per kilogram. That's a lot, per kilogram. In fact, according to NASA, solar panels in space, or EnergyLink as I like to call it, will not be economically viable until the cost to get a kilogram into orbit is between $100 and $200. With Starship, the cost per kilogram will only be about $40. Assuming the worst case scenario, if the cost per kilogram doubles, the cost is still less than $100, which makes EnergyLink extremely viable. As for profitability, the New York Power Authority has a revenue of $2.5 billion per year. This is compared to the approximately $64 million that it would take to get EnergyLink to go into space and power Earth for decades. That's almost 100 times cheaper. Imagine what EnergyLink would do worldwide, both economically and in improving people's lives. But why would we even put the solar arrays in space? Why not just leave them here on Earth? Well, in space, the solar arrays would be 40 times as efficient, because they would be closer to the sun with no atmosphere blocking the light. In addition, solar arrays in geosynchronous orbit would provide much more reliable electricity since they are exposed to the sun 99.9% of the time, unlike solar panels here, which experience night and day. Now that we've established it's economically viable and extremely profitable, let's look at how it would work. First, Starship would get the solar panel array to geosynchronous orbit. There, it would part and unfold. Now, once the energy link has been unfolded, it would have a diameter of 80 meters. And since 8 of them could power all of New York, the impact this would have on the world would be incredible. Now, there's one more thing. Atop the energy link, there would be a giant mirror to concentrate the sun's energy. With that, you could make each energy link produce 2.5 gigawatts, or around an eighth of what New York consumes. Basically, it's a lot, but how do you get the energy back down to Earth? Well, that's where the transmitter comes in. Solar panels convert photons into electrons, and then the transmitter converts those electrons into lasers, which would then be transmitted down to Earth to our antenna. The antenna is basically a field full of wires sticking up, waiting to catch the lasers. The antenna would receive the waves and convert them into electricity that we would use to power our lives. Although the infrastructure is a lot, the amount of electricity this would produce basically indefinitely once the infrastructure was built compared to the current costs make it extremely worthwhile. As you can see by this infographic, we have all the technology and the process is quite simple. But what was holding us back was that it simply wasn't economically practical until now with Starship. Thank you for watching and I'll see you on Mars.